Good morning.
Good morning, teacher.
How are you today? Fine?
Yes.
Today we are going to start making our revision worksheet 2 for semester 2. In this sheet, we are going to revise about the parallelogram, second lesson, which is the literal fractions, and about the compound fractions. Are you ready?
Yes.
Question number one. Read question number one, Ali, please.
Given the fraction 3x plus 2 over 3 minus 2x, what is 8 1?
When we are given a literal fraction, and this literal fraction is defined when, Ali? When is it defined?
It's defined when the sum of the denominator is
When the denominator is different from zero. What is the denominator here?
Here, 3 minus 2x.
So the denominator is 3 minus 2x.
It shouldn't be equal to zero.
Yes. So 3 minus 2x, which is the denominator, it should be different from zero, which means minus 2x should be different from how zero? We take 3 to the next,
from,
if we take 3, it becomes negative 3, then x should be different from, minus 3 over, what's the sign of 2? Over minus 2, then x should be different from, 3 over 2. So, A, the fraction A to be defined, x should be any value other than 3 over 2. X can be 0, it can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 4, it can be minus 7, it can be minus 2. Any value of for x except x equal to 3 over 2. If we write instead of x 3 over 2, the denominator becomes 0, then the fraction will be undefined, so it's wrong, okay? Now part B, we should find the numerical value of A for x equal to minus 2 dana. So we should substitute instead of x, what should we write the value?
Minus 2.
Tell me, what should I write?
3
into
minus 2
plus 2 over
3 minus
2. Yes. Into
minus
2. Yes. 3 times minus 2
minus
6
plus
2 over 3 minus times minus
plus
2 times 2
4.
Now minus 2 plus 6. Who's the greater, 6 or 2? So minus 6 plus 2, so it's minus and we subtract. 6 minus 2. 4, 3 plus 4,
7.
So if x is equal to minus 2, what is the value of A? The value of A is minus 4 over 7. Question number 2, Hassan. We should simplify these literal fractions. The first one, to simplify, is to find a common factor between the numerator and the denominator. First, we start with the numbers 14 and 21. The common between 14 and 21 is, if we simplify 14 by 7 is 2, 21 by 7 it is 3. Can we reduce 2 and 3 anymore? So we write 2 over 3. Now, up we have x cubed, down we have x squared. X up, y and y cube.
Y cube.
Y. What's the power? Y. Y up and y cube down. The answer is, when you simplify, is y squared. If above you have z to the power 4 down, we cancel z to the power 4 with z to the power 4, so the answer is 2x over 3y squared. Now, Ala, we have minus 24 and 18. What's common between minus 24 and 18? We divide up by 6 is? Minus 4. If we divide down by 6, can we reduce minus 4 and 3? So we have minus 4 over 3. Now we start with the variables. A squared up, A cubed down.
A down.
B5 up, B4 down. B up. Down we have C. Up we don't have C. C down. So the answer is minus 4B over 3AC. Question number 3, we should perform operations on literal fractions. The first one, which operations, Selena, do we have? Addition. We should see if. Which case do we have here? Like fractions, so the denominator is 5. The numerator?
2x minus 3 plus
4x. Plus 4x. Okay. Now, the denominator is 5. The numerator is?
6x.
Yes. 6x minus 3, we perform the variables together, okay? Now, in the second one, Dana, we have 2a minus 3a minus 1 over 4. Here we have which operation? Which operation? Subtraction. We have the first one, we put it over 1. So, unlike fractions or like fractions, we should make them. How do we make them like? Is? Yes. Now, 4 divided by 1? 4 times 2a?
8a.
It is 8a. Minus. 4 over 4?
1.
We should multiply 1 by? Only 3? By 3a?
Minus
1. Okay? Now, we have the denominator is 4. 8a. Now we multiply the minus with the numbers inside. Minus times the 3a. Minus the 3a. Minus times minus 1.
Plus
1. Now 8a minus the 3a. 8a minus the 3a is? 5a. Plus 1. So the answer is 5a plus 1 over 4. Now in the third one, Hassan, we have multiplication of two literal fractions. How can we make multiplication? We multiply numerator by numerator, denominator by denominator. 6 times 1? M squared. N squared. T to the power 5. Okay? Now, down which number do we have? First, we put the number. What's the number down?
9.
M squared. N. T cubed. Now, what should we do? Simplify. 6 and 9 by?
3.
By 3 up. 2 by 3 down. So, the numbers are 2 over 3. M squared up, M squared down,
cancel
together. N squared over N,
up,
T5 up, T cubed down. T squared up, so the answer is 2N T squared over 3. The fourth one, we have minus 4 Ali A cubed B. Over divided by 6a squared over b. Yes, how can we solve the division?
Yes, we have the first fraction as it is.
As it is.
Yes.
The reciprocal of the second fraction, okay? Now multiply the numerator by numerator.
Minus 4.
Yes.
6a squared.
A squared. Now minus over plus. 4 and 6 we reduce by 2 up, by 2 down. So we have 2 over 3. A cube up, A squared down. Yes. B squared. Do you have any question? Question number 4, we should calculate part A. Here we are calculating, what do we call these? Compound fractions. So here we are calculating compound fractions. The first fraction, 1 over 2 over 7. First, what should we write? 1 over 1, right?
Yes.
How can we solve compound fractions? We multiply far, far,
near,
near, okay? So it will give me a fraction. Yes, we multiply. We write 1 times 7, 1 times 2. Can we simplify this fraction? So we multiply 1 times 7, 1 times 2. Thank you, Ala. Now part B, Dana. Yes.
-6/1.
So -6/1.
And now we're far, far, near, near.
Far, far, near, near. -6 × 7.
-14.
No, we write -6 × 7/1.
1 times.
4. Can you reduce this?
No. Yes,
6 not by 4. There is a common factor between 6 and 4, which is?
2.
If we reduce 6 by 2, it is?
Minus 3.
Minus 3. If we reduce 4 by 2, it is?
2.
Any other common factors?
No.
-3 × 7?
-21.
1 times 2?
2.
Thank you. Muhammad. -9/7/-15/11. Far, far, near, near. So, -9, we multiply it by?
11.
And?
7 × -15.
We write the minus first, okay? -15, we multiply it by 7. Is there any common factor between up and down?
Yes.
First, the minus with the minus, they cancel each other, okay?
Yeah.
Between which numbers now? 9 and 15, we have a common factor, which is 3. 9/3, 15/3, 5, okay? 3 × 11, Muhammad? 33. 5 × 7? 5 × 7, Ala? 35. Now, part D. Here we have a complex compound fraction, okay? Start, Ali.
At first, we want to calculate the above.
Yes, the above in the numerator. So we write 1 plus
2/2.
Down we have 1 minus 2/3. These are like or unlike fractions?
Unlike.
Unlike. So what's the common denominator?
3/1.
3/1 times 1,
3.
3/3 times minus 2,
minus 2.
Now down, what do we write? 2 minus
1 over.
Yes. Common denominator is 3/1 times 2, 3/3 times 1, 1. Okay. Now, 1 plus 3 minus 2, so we write 1/3. Down we write, yes, 5/3. So we write 1 plus, now we have a compound fraction, 2/1, far, far, near, near. So, 2 times 3. 1 times 1,
1,
okay? Down we have
2 minus
also 1 over 1. So 1 times 3 is 5 times 1, okay? Now What's the answer up? What do we mean by 6 over 1?
6.
6 plus 1? So the answer up is 7, right?
Yeah.
Now down we have unlike fractions. What's the common denominator?
5.
5 over 1?
5.
Times 2?
10.
5 over 5?
1.
Times the 3?
3.
Okay. Now we have 7 over 10 minus 3?
7
over, what do we write up? 7 over 1, okay? Now, it's equal to 7 times 5 over 1 times 7. We reduce by 7 up, 7 down. 1 times 5, 5. 1 times 1, so the answer is 5, okay? Question number 5, we should solve these equations. Equation A. Yes, Ala. Read the equation. These are direct equations. What do we call these kind of equations? What do we call them? These are first degree equations. Who can tell me what do we mean by first degree equations? Yes, Ali. No, the exponent of the variable is 1. So, Ala, 3x equal 9. X equal 9 over 3. We reduce by. So, the x is equal to 9 over 3 is 3. So, the value of x is a 3. Part B. Yes, Dana, 4a equal minus 6.
A
equal
minus
6
over
4. We reduce by
2.
The answer is
minus
3 over 2. Part C, minus 5b equal minus 7. Muhammad. B equal
minus
7 over minus 5. Yes. We reduce the signs. Now, minus 8y equal 4, Hassan.
Y equal?
Yes.
4 over minus
8. Yes.
Equal.
Y equal, we reduce by?
4.
By 4 up?
1.
By 4 down?
2.
Minus 2. Now, part E. A minus 6 equal minus 4, Selena.
A equal?
Minus 4. If we take minus 6 to the other side, it will become plus 6. So A equals 2. Now part F. 2C Ala plus 5 equal minus 1. 2C. Yes. Yes. 2C equal
minus
6. C equal over 2, yes, minus 3. Part G, Ali.
G, 4A plus 7 equal 9, write 4A equal
9, yes.
And 1, 7, 9.
9 minus 7.
4A equal
2.
And A
2 over
A equal
we reduce by, yes, 1 over 2. Now part H, 2 into minus 3y plus 5 equal minus 2. Yes, Hassan. Here we should get rid of the parentheses first. Yes, 2 times minus 3.
Minus
6. Minus 6 what? Y, 2 times plus 5,
plus
equal to,
minus
2, yes,
minus
6y, equal to,
minus
2, yes,
minus
10,
minus 6y equal to, minus
12,
y equal 12, 12.
Where's the sign, Hassan?
Minus
12.
Minus
12.
Over
9, 6. Yes, then y equal?
2.
Minus 2. Question number 6 is the geometry part. We have Ali.
ABC is a triangle. I is the root of AB of segment AB and G is the measurement of segment BC. Construct upper symmetry of A with respect to G.
So, we are given a triangle ABC, it's drawn, finished, okay? I is the midpoint of AB. We look at the segment AB, at the side AB. What should we do to locate I? We measure AB and we locate I at the midpoint of AB. So, this is I. Always on the figure, we should mark the midpoint, okay? How do we mark the midpoint? What do we mean by I is the midpoint of AB? IA is equal to IB, then IA is equal to IB. You see these marks, we should put them on our drawing, okay? And J is the midpoint of BC. Also, we measure BC and we take the midpoint, which is
J.
JC equal to JB. Now, we should construct F. What is F? The symmetry of A with respect to J. We should join A with? We join A with J. What do? We measure AJ and we take the same measure, which is F. Who are equal here? JA is equal to JF, okay? Now part A, we should prove that ACFB is a
parallelogram.
How can we prove that ACFB is a parallelogram? Dana, what do you have in quadrilateral ACFB? Yes, what do you have? Look at the diagonals, Dana. A, C, F, B.
Looks like G is the midpoint.
J is the midpoint of B, C. Then? J, B is equal to? J, C. Because J is midpoint of what? Of segment BC. And J is also the midpoint of whom? Then JA is equal to JF because J is the symmetric, which means the midpoint of FA. From these two, what do you conclude? Then ACFB is a
parallelogram.
Why? Because the diagonals bisect each others. Okay? Now part B. In part B, D is the midpoint of CF. If we look at CF, we take D, the midpoint of CF. This is equal to this. DF is equal to DC, okay? We should prove that BICD is a parallelogram. How do we prove that BICD is a parallelogram? Yes, Ali.
FC
is equal to BA.
And FC is midpoint, then FD is equal to DC.
FD is equal to DC.
D is the midpoint of FC.
Yes.
And BI will be equal to DC.
First of all, we say that because we said that ACFB is a parallelogram, right?
Yes.
Then FC C is parallel to BA, which means DC is parallel to BA, okay? To BI, sorry. To BI. And DC is equal to BI, then quadrilateral, which is BICD, is a parallelogram having what? Two equal sides and parallel, okay? Then this quadrilateral is a parallelogram, okay? Okay, thank you.